Hi everyone, it's Dr. Glenna Rice and I'm here with the amazing, beautiful Rachel O'Brien. And we are doing some fun conversations about business and bodies. And I'd like to talk a little bit about, are you forcing your body or are you asking your body to contribute to your business? And what's different about that? We're all really good at the forcing part. That's how we are trained to function in it.
Yeah. So if it's your first time coming across Glenna and I, we've created these series of videos looking at questions that allow you to go beyond the force of this reality. We're actually trained, get up, push yourself out of bed, you know, go to work when you're sick. In the Irish Navy point of view is you work hard and there's pride in working hard. And also Americans' point of view.
Oh, yeah.
Work. So what we're inviting you today is to ask questions that allow you to look at your entrained points of views about your body and about forcing your body. Now, I would like to say, if you're watching this, for me, I grew up forcing my body. This is what you did. You got up out of bed no matter what was going on, and you didn't stop until you fell down or got sick. That was literally my pattern. Work hard, burnout, work hard, burnout, work hard, burnout.
It sounds so much fun.
Oh, listen.
Just joy everywhere. Just working your fingers to the bone. Yeah, we value hard work way more than work that's ease. And what's so interesting is when you work with ease, you create so much more. You create more when you're asking your body, when you know what you have to create, and your body's included in the entire creation, which pretty much everything we create with business has our body included at some level. You get more done than you can imagine when you're not having this point of view about hard work that Rachel was just talking about. I mean, that's valuable here. Ease is not valuable, but ease
is effortless is not valuable.
What's that?
Effortless is not valuable.
Well, and when it's effortless, if you can just go back to some time in your life when something you created was effortless, where you sat there and were creating and you forgot to eat and you didn't go to the bathroom and you didn't go to sleep and all of a sudden it was 2 a.m. and all of this amazing stuff was completed with effortlessness. Did you create more then, or do you create more when you force yourself? And this is a choice we all can make. Would you like to create with force? Would you like to ask your body to be included? And what would it take to create this with more ease than we can imagine?
Can you just, before we finish for today, can you just talk to people about the difference in choosing? So you said choosing ease, choosing that ease with your body and asking that body. So some people have no idea what you mean by choice. So can you just talk a little bit about when you recognize and identify, acknowledge that you've been entrained to force your body, to override your body, to not care for your body, to not nurture your body, to not ask your body questions, you know? Can you talk to people about what is it that they can be that would allow them to start looking at, hey, I've actually got a choice here. I don't have to force.
You know, it's so simple that people will probably dismiss this, but it's really your body, not forcing your body. Body, how would you like to create this? Body, would you like to create this? I just was out last weekend and I had to help my mother clean out a trailer that my parents had lived in for quite a few years that had actually been broken into. It was a mess. It was just me and my mom. We walked open the door to this trailer that's been sitting for a couple of years. We hadn't been out there in a few years and we were just like, oh. And I looked at it and I was just, the whole thing, this is going to be so much work. How are we going to do this? Oh my God, this is terrible. And I went, okay, Mom, what would it take for us to get everything done that's required here with ease? Now our bodies had to do this. We cleaned, we threw out bags and bags of garbage. We cleaned every corner cabinet to get it ready to sell. And 2 days later, it was immaculate. And both of us felt awesome. We were both excited. We were both happy. We completed this amazing task. And that hard work moment, I don't think it was in any of those 2 days. She was working here. I was working here. And everything started to just change. And, you know, the trailer contributed to us creating because we were asking for an ease with it to get what was required completed without the energy of, oh, my God, this is hard work. So it's simply just changing your point of view to a point of view where you can create things with ease and including your body in that creation.
And as Glenna said, it's so simple, you may dismiss it. For me, waking up in the morning and just being like, hey body, what do you desire? What do you require? Acknowledging my body and just knowing that ease with my body, that I can have a space of peace and ease is available for me. That actually, whatever that does for me in the morning, it's like, the only way that I can explain it, Glenna, it's like these barriers, these walls of how difficult life can be, how difficult life is. It's like what it does is it just goes, whoosh, they just melt and my body's like, hi.
Yeah. And it's so amazing how your body will just go, okay. Yeah, I've had those mornings where I arrived somewhere and I had 3 hours sleep and had to get up and teach a class. And I was, oh my gosh, how am I going to do this? And I'm like, okay, body, we teach classes. This is our business. This is what we create. What do you require to have ease with today? Are you cool with it? I mean, are you cool with this? Can we do this? Can you get up? And my body's like, yeah, you know what? This has never been my point of view. It's yours. Let's go. Let's
you
go.
Know what? I'm so grateful you talked about this. I think I went to sleep last night at 3 a.m. and I had a meeting with Lauren Marie. You know Lauren Marie at 8.
Yeah.
And I could sense the point of view coming in last night at 3 a.m. about, oh my God, I'm going to only get this and blah, blah, blah. And I just went, this is just such a load of fixed points of views. The fact that I'm awake at 3 a.m., if my body required to sleep, guess what, Glenna? I'd be sleeping, you know?
Yeah.
So I wake at 7 a.m., not 8 a.m., and then I'm like, body, are we good to go? Yeah.
And that's the beauty of asking and including your body. It's just that simple. Body, are you good to go? You require anything right now? You ready to go? We're going to start creating our lives today? What grand and glorious adventures are we going to have?
Yeah. How does it get any better? So check out the Access Body processes. Check out the 3-day classes. These actually will open the door for you to embodying the consciousness of the communion with your body. I mean, this is a major part of Access, the Access Body work, because mm-hmm. everybody's got a body. And, you know, if you don't start to nurture and I want to say build a relationship or build a communion yeah. with your body,
yeah.
your body's probably going to disintegrate and age and get old and, you know, create the fixed points of views that were given from this reality. But what we would really like you to know is there is a different possibility available, and that's what this series is about.
Yes, thank you. Yeah, including your body.
Thanks for watching.